That was fucking scary, kid. We almost had technical difficulties, but we're good. EarlyMorningMob.com, the Golden Debate Show. Like, comment, share, and download. Now you can talk.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
Down there in one of those catacombs. This other guy.
Like, comment, share, and download. And shine the golden advance lights. Honest eyes. Yeah, we're off to a good bad start already. That means we're going to have a good show.
Fuck yeah.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
The golden debate show.
Yeah, the golden debate show.
Let's get it in with that man 2 minute news from YouTube.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of News and Tune, bringing you the news that you need to know every day. Let's begin. As tensions between Russia and the United States increase and drones are being deployed in record numbers, the Russian military is set to begin using a cutting-edge form of anti-spying technology that is designed to block aircraft-based electronic surveillance. As technicians in Japan started the dangerous process of removing the highly radioactive fuel rods from reactor number 4 at the Fukushima nuclear power plant, researchers around the world are reinforcing concerns that while fuel removal is a necessary task to ensure the decommissioning of the site, it is possibly one of the most dangerous times that the site will have experienced since the tsunami that swept past its walls in March of 2011. An assistant professor at Kyoto University's Research Reactor Institute is quoted as mentioning that the timing of the fuel rod removal was crucial, as the reactor's storage pool is in an unstable condition and the process could be further hampered by even moderate earthquakes that strike near the removal site. Analysts point out that the process of removing the fuel will take nearly 12 months, with the entire world cringing at every sizable earthquake near the Fukushima nuclear power plant, waiting for a delayed release of information as to whether radioactive materials have been leaked during the process. Sectarian violence is continuing to disrupt daily life in Pakistan as violent religious unrest caused the deaths of multiple people following clashes near the country's capital and prompting the Pakistani government to impose a 24-hour curfew and block mobile phone service over the weekend. The World Health Organization has confirmed the first two cases of the Middle Eastern Respiratory Syndrome in the country of Kuwait as the virus continues to spread beyond the borders of Saudi Arabia. In related news, Saudi Arabian officials have been quick to openly deny claims that the Saudi Arabian military was working with Israel and a number of other Middle Eastern countries to target Iran's nuclear weapons program after a continued political and ideological fallout with the United States. Military analysts with sources close to the Middle East stressed that the abrupt denial, without much mention of the straining ties that both Israel and Saudi Arabia are experiencing with the United States, could suggest that both of the countries are quietly following Egypt's lead to seek military alliances outside of the American umbrella of assistance. And to wrap things up, the leader of Venezuela has been given the presidential authority to create laws without consulting Congress for a 12-month period. Twin suicide bombs
avoiding salts could be a way to cure snoring. At least that's what Brazilian researchers want to prove. They started a study last month hoping to uncover a connection between salt and sleep apnea. Researchers believe excessive salt intake builds up fluid in the body, and then the fluid shifts to a person's neck when they're lying down. Some patients will take a diuretic pill, and others will switch to a low-salt diet to see what works to treat sleep apnea.
We're goners. I'm sorry I can't figure a way out of this mess like
this
I usually do.
Hey, Brad, would you mind punching me just one last time?
Sure, Blackstein. Of course I will.
Ow.
I can't believe I'm going to die a virgin.
Amber, last week when you weren't looking, I totally popped your cherry.
Aww, science.
You're the best on the show.
Okay, this is it.
You all heard me say freeze, right?
Ew! The murderer's so ugly!
Well, that depends on your political convictions. You see, that isn't his face. It's a man!
Eyes are awesome.
Oh, that's not even the half of it. You can do all sorts of things with eyes. Did you know that you can blink them and roll them and wink them and close them and make them real wide or real squinty or...
Hey! How do you know so much about eyes?
Yeah, you seem unusually confident on our little field trip to the early 90s.
Aren't you worried about getting an F?
Not this time. I'm used to not using technology. Being half black, half Jewish, I take part in a cool ancient ritual called Shabbat every other week.
Neat. What's Shabbat?
It's the Jewish day of rest when God doesn't want you to use electricity for 24 hours.
OMG, you are so boring. Is this what it's like giving someone your full attention?
This is the worst.
All they insisted that Al-Qaeda is having a field day with the leaked information.
It was their first joint appearance before lawmakers, the heads of domestic and foreign intelligence agencies MI5 and MI6, and electronic surveillance agency GCHQ told the committee they were struggling to thwart terrorism in the age of the internet.
It means that we have to anticipate, discover, analyze, investigate, and respond, and we have to do so globally because the threat is coming at us globally.
GCHQ gathers and processes vast amounts of internet and telephone data originating in the UK and abroad. The agency head said the information leaked by Edward Snowden had made their work more difficult by changing the behavior of the terrorist groups they monitor.
What I can tell you is that the leaks from Snowden have been very damaging. They put our operations at risk. It is clear that our adversaries are rubbing their hands with glee.
The recent spying allegations involving the British embassy in Berlin were not discussed. When asked about spying on Britain's allies, Sowers said MI6 operated in very few countries and its priorities were set by the government.
One mother is caught between a rock and a hard place. Followed by Pennsylvania judge recently told her that she had to stop breastfeeding her 10-month-old daughter so the little girl could stay with her father for 2 days a week. It's part of a custody agreement, but the mom says there's nothing agreeable about it.
He did say something along the lines like, well, she should be on formula, or why isn't she on formula? She should be able to have formula at 10 months old. I'm feeling frustrated, hurt. I'm trying to keep myself from crying.
Some herbal supplements may not be what they seem. Researchers in Canada use DNA barcoding to test 44 different supplements. They found some were often diluted or replaced entirely with fillers like soybean and rice. One third showed no trace of the plant advertised on the bottle, only another plant in its place.
70 good.
GMOs.
Ain't no fillers here. It's Jake Golden. Tell him where to go.
Go to the baby show live with Carl Calzone. Tony Tortellini. Straight Golden in the Golden Temple.
Science.
Golden show.
Alrighty. This is science.
Grab the ashtray and take a toe from the lie. Hit the folks outside. Kids cutting school. Grab the remote.
The Golden Show. It's Golden.
Steam up the bathroom to the mirror's fog. Can't wait the ball with my niggas call. Dry off, splash on the Izzy Miyak. Cut up the rock, head for the door. Oops, forgot. You know I can't leave my chrome. That's my love, Jones. Niggas in front of the building. Niggas making the killing. But when I come through, niggas catching their feelings. Cause the fiends follow, cause my bottles be spilling. I can hear him now.
What do you get a shit from Brazilians? Gotta be good. Look at the fiends leaving their children.
And that's fucked up. Niggas mad cause my pocket's fucked up. When my click for the truck up. Yo, hold up.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody.
Down there in one of those catacombs. There's other guys, what they look like. I don't know.
This don't make no sense, everybody.
Science. Science.
Hey, yo, go down to the fifth. Huh? You know where D&M be standing thick.
What?
Fucking with them chicks that strippin'. Niggas that claim they spit, but all I hear is they want out.
Like oh,
I
got my
mouth. Running off at the mouth. You're off, let's be out. Back to the BX. Boy, you blue Chevy. Followed by the GS. Keep the gun heavy. Just the case in BS. Cause niggas like the test man. Should I say the rest? Hop on the cellar.
Yo, hit the nigga. This nigga say he ain't got my money. And I just don't believe him. So we gonna give him a little scare.
Put that mac and cheese, everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
Now I'm missing shit. The closet's unroomy. Plus for me, that's unruly.
Number 25. Emperor Justin II. As the Byzantine emperor from 565 to 576, Justin reportedly began to lose his mind near the end of his reign. He was pushed around the palace on a wheelchair, snapping at attendants as he passed, and even reportedly ate a few of them. Number 24. Ibrahim of the Ottoman Empire. An Ottoman sultan known to have an obsession with fat women, he had his agents track down the fattest one possible. He also had 280 of his concubines drowned in the ocean when he heard they had slept with another man, and he would regularly feed coins to fish in the palace pool. Number 23. King Charles VI of France. Before going mad, he was apparently known as Charles the Well-Loved. Afterwards, he became Charles the Mad. Reportedly killing his own knights after one of them dropped a spear, he also refused to bathe and for a long time believed he was made of glass. Number 22. Anna of Russia. Although she was placed on the throne by old nobles hoping that she would be a figurehead, she not only assumed power by her wooing of the Imperial Guards, but she was found to love cool jokes, especially on the nobles who appointed her. Number 21. Eric XIV of Sweden. Known for being insanely paranoid, he was known to have people executed simply for laughing in his presence. He even believed he was his own brother for a while. Eventually, though, his worst fears came true and he died of poisoning. Number 20. Princess Alexandra of Bulgaria. She somehow became convinced that as a child she swallowed a glass piano. She also had an obsession with cleanliness and would only wear white. Number 19. Ferdinand I of Austria. A product of inbreeding, he was epileptic and syphilitic and rarely talked. In fact, it has been stated that the only words he ever said were, "I am the emperor and I want dumplings." Number 18. The Zhengde Emperor of China.
Dumpling me up.
China in the beginning of the 16th century, this guy was known for playing make-believe in the royal gardens and forcing everyone to play along with him. Number 17. Farouk of Egypt. The last ruling king of Egypt, Farouk was known as a stomach with a head after he grew to over 300 pounds. What was most bizarre, though, was his kleptomania. He even stole a watch from his
original.
His most famous act, however, he went to the zoo and shot all the lions after having nightmares. Number 16. Frederick Wilhelm I of Prussia. Remembered for his affection towards the military, Frederick was obsessed with creating the biggest fighting unit ever. And by biggest, we mean tallest. He was even recorded as forcing tall men and women to have kids. Number 15. Qin Shi Huang of China. Known for being terrified of being assassinated, he never slept in the same place twice. It wasn't just humans he was wary of, though. Apparently, he feared a giant sea monster as well. Number 14. Juana I of Spain. Also known as Juana the Mad, she was so scared that her husband would cheat on her that even after he died, she wouldn't let any woman come near his corpse.
With my golden silk pajamas on, smoking Havanas, drinking Don P, thinking beyond deeper than Gandhi. While I'm in a Diamante, counting my jeans, I'm out to be a millionaire. Dipped in gear, flicking $100 bills in the air. Oh yeah, Cuba Link is into getting Benjamins. Cause if it doesn't make dollars, then it doesn't make sense. I represent, I'm in to be the king of New York. Went from living in tenements to a penthouse resort. I'm the Latino, that'll take you to war like Al Pacino. Even
not to gamble in my casino. Shut up,
Marty.
It's just
a science. I got shit locked from to the tropics, sitting on top of the world like the sun.
Put that mac and cheese, everybody. Deserves their mac and cheese.
There's other guys, what it looks like. I don't know.
Just don't make those no sense, everybody.
Get that mac and cheese. Deserves their mac and cheese.
This don't make no sense, everybody.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
This other guy's at the
party. It's just science.
I'm trying to wake you up,
everybody.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
It's just science. What they look like, I don't know.
Just don't make no sense, everybody.
Get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
There's other guys, what they look like. I don't know.
Just don't make no sense, everybody.
get that mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
There's other guys, what they look like. I don't know.
This don't make no sense to everybody.
Let's see how well this thing works out, Tom. Can I read, yo?
Yeah, yes, I can, yo. We could do it, Crip.
Can't read anyway.
We'll try, though.
We keep it gold. We're breathing in mold.
We rolling gold, yo.
We can't read, yo. We can't read, yo. Yeah, we keep the
yes. Two tones ready on the mic. And now I will be talking about the 7 states rejecting the Obama insurance proposal. At least if you live in one of the 7 states that have rejected the president's Barack Obama's proposals to allow health insurance companies to renew plans not in compliance with the Affordable Care Act. The proposal was meant to help the president keep his promise to millions of Americans who have received canceled notices from the insurance providers and would allow companies to renew current plans for 1 year while people transition to their federal insurance exchange. Because the insurance is regulated differently in each state, the president plans to require approval from governors and state insurance commissions. Many who have been hesitant to make changes for the 2021-14. On Tuesday, New York became the largest state to reject the proposal. Governor Andrew Cuomo, Democrat, told reporters during a press conference he doesn't think the president's fix is necessary for New York. We haven't had those kinds of issues in New York in our exchange that have nationwide, Cuomo said. Our programs has actually been working well. The website has been working well, and we've had actually good success with our programs. So we don't see any reason to change it now because we're not having those types of issues. New York joins Washington, Rhode Island, Vermont, Massachusetts, Minnesota, Indiana in rejecting the president's proposal.
Very good. Yeah. Look at that. I can't even make fun of you because you actually did a good job and we got the jingle to make fun of us and everything. Like, comment, share, and download.
Bookworm levels up.
Science.
Down there, one of those
show party. It's
just
science.
What they look like? I don't know.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up. I'm just
welcome
trying
to the
wake
InfoWars
you up,
nightly
everybody.
News. I'm David Knight. It's Tuesday, November 19th, 2013, and here are our top stories.
Vampire news.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
tonight, InfoWars prepares to take over the controlled narrative of the JFK assassination.
Yes, the other guys, not us.
Then, will you have to surrender
that
biometrics
vampire.
Just to That's next.
Don't be InfoWars.
Don't talk about him. Don't listen to him. Listen, he's the kook saying the government can't be trusted. He's the kook saying there's tyranny. He's the kook saying there's...
That ain't good.
Well, as the 50th anniversary of the JFK assassination approaches this Friday, the city of Dallas is in a ham-fisted way censoring any free speech, any skepticism about the official story. But we're not taking this lying down. Texans are going to be protesting the censorship of free speech in Dallas. On Wednesday, Alex Jones will kick off 3 days of demonstrations and protests at the Federal Reserve Building at the corner of Pearl and Woodall Rogers Freeway, location he's previously demonstrated at
already
three separate times with
greats.
Other
yeah,
Americans.
You know,
we are not going to be pushed aside as they do at the political conventions into free speech zones. That is clearly unconstitutional. Look at the First Amendment. This is specifically protected speech under the First Amendment. The right of the people peaceably to assemble and petition the government with grievances. We have grievances. We have grievances about the official story. It does not honor the memory of JFK to not have a honest investigation, to cover up.
Now you know your neighborhood.
To
keep an eye
things
on
aside,
a stranger taking a shortcut.
Think that your president got assassinated or something?
Report him.
Strange car parked illegally.
If you see a snitch, snitching, and you report. report that motherfucker. The reports are so fucking reported that the reports have been reported on a whole bit of tape.
Report it. If you see a prowler at night, don't frighten him away.
Remember, by helping us apprehend a criminal, we'll make sure that you are not his next victim.
Earlymorningmob.com.
George Clooney is a spy.
Being crafted in real time. Anyone who's alive remembers this. And it was a period of time when we learned that our government was capable of the same sorts of things that we see in banana republics that we saw in Nazi Germany. It was an important lesson, one that we must not forget. And I think it's interesting that just today we learned something about a Nazi assassination, a Nazi cover-up. We learned that Field Marshal Rommel, who was involved in an assassination plot against Hitler, was actually forced to commit suicide. Now, this happened back in 1944. And
get that
the
mac and cheese. Everybody deserves their mac and cheese.
The report under threat of being killed by an SS officer, Dr. Friedrich Breiterhoff, actually made a report to the police.
We interrupt
in 1960.
With a special
seven-page report.
America is now under martial law.
Forced suicide.
Constitutional rights have been suspended. Stay in your home. Do not attempt to contact loved ones, insurance agents, or attorney. Shut up. Do not attempt to think or depression may occur. Stay in your home.
What does this
Diabetes, cholesterol over 190, heart rate is greater than 7.5%. You're probably going to be prescribed a statin drug. And if you look at the projections, they say about 35, 36 million people are taking the drugs now. It could literally double. It could go to 70 to 76 million people within the next few years. What they're not sure of, and a very important question is, will it actually prolong life in the vast majority of people? And that still remains to be seen.
Time now for the
Science.
News Nation Gut Check. An article in the latest issue of Guns and Ammo has elicited such a strong backlash from readers that the editor is stepping down from the magazine after firing the guy who wrote the piece. The column was written by Dick Metcalf. He wrote about his take on the Second Amendment, saying in part, quote, too many gun owners still seem to believe that any regulation of the right to bear and keep arms is an infringement. The fact is, all constitutional rights are regulated and need to be.
Mexico City has been invaded by peace-loving clowns. Coming from all over Latin America, they were in town for the 18th annual clown convention. Though their business may be laughs, they had a serious message. They wanted to spread their message of peace in the country, which has seen 600,000 deaths due to drug-related violence in the last 7 years. We want peace since there's so much violence in Mexico. We know how the situation is right now. We want a little bit of peace. We spread happiness, laughter, smiles. That's why we're clowns.
It took her 7 hours on the phone and online. Eventually, she had to go through and clean out all the cookies from her cachet, and then she was able to sign up. But she did sign up from the small city state of Delaware.
Well underway, bringing some of the most talented experts to bear on this problem, and they're working 24/7 on fixing the website. And I understand that HHS is now announcing some key steps, including the fact that it is bringing in management expert and former CEO on board to work in close cooperation with the HHS team to provide management advice and counsel to the project. As those of you know Jeff, he's an expert in the field of effective management. HHS will be tapping his experience and expertise as they address the challenges that have come up with the administration of the website.
Science!
Get that mac and cheese, everybody.
Shut up!
Deserves that mac and cheese.
How reckless of me. I made you all wet.
Yes, but my martini's still dry. My name's James.
Hello, James.
He is talking about
personal
privacy.
Everybody.
Do you want your phone tapped?
I'm not planning on going up the country.
Well, how do we know until we've heard all your dirty little secrets?
You're just gonna have to trust me.
Oh, I know. We'll just tap the criminals. We won't suspend the civil rights of the good people.
Right.
Then who decides which is which?
I think you should.
You know, Bobby, I think you should take this more seriously.
Mama, but we do not want you to miss history in the making, and that is what we have right now at the International Space Station.
It's really cool. Look at this. The Olympic torch is on its first spacewalk. Two Russian cosmonauts carried out of the International Space Station. Now, the torch has been in space before, 96 for the Atlanta Summer Games, but not outside of the spacecraft. The torch will leave tomorrow with three crew members who are returning to Earth. Now, they were, for just a moment ago, holding the torch, waving. Of course, it was not lit because there's no oxygen to support a flame in space. But then this is going to continue on the relay route leading up to the Winter Games in Sochi, Russia.
Yeah, take a look at it. This cannot be easy, you know, maneuvering anything out there. But then...
Hi, we wanted to give you an update on an issue that I get asked about a lot in the White House briefing room. It's called the Employment Non-Discrimination Act, and the Senate is discussing this important, critically important piece of legislation this week. The bill provides strong federal protections against discrimination, making it explicitly illegal to fire someone who is gay, lesbian, bisexual, or transgender. But only 17 states currently prohibit discrimination against LGBT members. As a result, millions of Americans across the country go to work every day.
All right, let me change the subject a little bit, because there was a big win in New York, your home, for Bill de Blasio.
You ran against him. To ensure that people can board planes safely. Take flights safely. The responsibility for protecting airport security is not a TSA function, but something that I think we need to certainly examine given what happened.
The head of the union representing officers with the Transportation Security Administration issued a statement calling for some of those officers to be armed in the aftermath of Friday's shooting at Los Angeles International Airport. The statement reads, in part, quote, "At this time, we feel a larger and more consistent armed presence in screening areas would be a positive step in improving security for both TSOs and the flying public. The development of a new class..."
I want to tell everybody here the truth. Hey, you know, fuck, I want to tell everybody here the truth. The politics for Obama aren't always great in Tennessee. I understand.
Heavy smog began shrouding the city over the weekend. Officials have been measuring levels of the pollutant PM2.5. They say the density in many locations on Sunday night exceeded 1,000 micrograms per cubic meter.
Picasso and Matisse has been found in the German city of Munich. The hall is believed to have been confiscated by the Nazis.
Well, it's just a stupid argument. I mean, whether or not this particular storm is anyone, if you have 99% of doctors who tell you you are sick and 1% that says, you're fine, you probably want to hang out with them, check it up for the 99, you know what I mean? I find this to be the most ridiculous argument ever.
The ghost of the darkness have come.
He's here.
See you on the other side.
I'm just trying to wake you up, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up.
Mr. President, if I could, it's the cost issue that's being driven by the fact that you've got in the bill, which I assume that your proposal supports, that the secretary define what a health benefit package should be.
Only in the exchange. If it only as part of the pool that people who don't have health insurance would buy into. If you are working at a big company that already has a big pool, then but you know what, I want to make sure, because Eric, we're going to end up in a back and forth that cuts everybody else out.
Report it.